All right, hello everybody, and welcome back to another Deepvue tutorial. Today I'm going to walk through how to create a market monitor dashboard like I have right here, which has the index ETFs. We've got net new highs, new lows. We've got breadth. We've got basically the key groups over here, the Mag 7 as well. And it kind of gives you everything you need to know in just one view, markets, groups, and then you can dive into the individual themes and stocks, but it gives you great kind of perspective and situational awareness about the overall health of the market. So we're gonna be creating this from scratch today. Really easy, should just take a couple minutes. I'm definitely gonna show you a few tricks in Deepvue that you hopefully didn't know before. And if you wanna try out Deepvue, we're running a special limited time offer, 2 months for $39. You can click the link that's popping up right now, as well as it's located down below in the description. Highly recommend checking it out, especially if you haven't given it a shot before, especially if you're a MarketSmith user, Market Surge user. Definitely give us a try. There's a whole lot more capability here in Deepvue and a lot more modern feel as well. And we're iterating very quickly, bringing new features and modules pretty much every single week and month. So with that said, and definitely use that offer, let's go ahead and dive right in. And first, actually taking a step back, what kind of is the dashboard module here in Deepvue? Well, it's kind of your personal playground that you can use to kind of create a, basically create a layout that suits a particular part of trading, whether it's monitoring the markets, whether it's trade execution, whether it's screening, watchlist management, you know, creating sizing for your positions. Basically, you can create these special templates and layouts that are very well suited to maximizing efficiency for one part of your trading process. So basically here in Deepvue, you can go ahead and create a new dashboard, create it, you know, make it whatever you want to do. We'll go ahead and name this tutorial. And let's go ahead and create that. And then you get a blank canvas, which then you'll be able to fill with different apps that will be incorporated into the platform. Currently, we have these five different modules: a charting element, a screening element, a deepless element with data columns, the stats table, which has earnings growth, sales growth, as well as estimates, and also the position size calculator, which we recently added to the platform, that allows you to fill in just a few fields and automatically calculate, you know, what should your position sizing be based on the risk you want to basically have on that position. Now, we're not just gonna be limited to these five elements. We'll be adding a whole lot later on this year and throughout this year and throughout the next few years. We've got some earnings apps planned, some performance charts, which kind of chart out a specific data point versus a watch list that allows you to track, for instance, you know, what stocks on your watch list have advanced the most from the open, stuff like that, in a very graphical manner that helps you decipher that data and, you know, doesn't just throw values at it, but presents it kind of graphically, easy on the eyes, that allows you to basically act on that information. So we'll be bringing a lot more apps to the dashboard in the future, but these are kind of the foundational elements. And then basically you can go ahead and drag these into this grid. You can organize them however you'd like, and basically fill up this space however you would like. And if we go back to the market monitor, just kind of breaking down the apps that I have here on the screen, we've got a charting element filling up the left-hand side of the screen, and then we have three different deepless elements. Looking at my execution screen, which will be a whole nother tutorial, we've got a very similar setup. We've got a charting element, which is on the right-hand side of the screen, and then three different deepless. Over here, we've got my focus list for the particular day. We've got my portfolio, and then we've got kind of a leaders list here. So again, three different chart elements. And you know, one of these could be an active screener. So, you know, you could be running a up on volume screen and have that right there for you, along with, you know, set deep lists, your focus list, as well as your portfolio. There's a ton of different ideas. I've already seen some really creative ideas posted from a bunch of Deepvue users. You can kind of take the dashboard and make it however you want. And just to show kind of one last example, here we've got the position size calculator top left. We've got a watch list here where, as you scroll through, you can see how this is lined up with this chart element. It also shows the position size you should buy based on the position size calculator here and the fields that you can fill out. And one more thing with the chart elements and deep lists, you can see in the top right-hand corner, you can activate, you know, and group different elements together. So say you wanted to have multiple chart elements and multiple lists, and one list should correspond with one chart, and the other one should also be grouped. You can set that up really easily using this group selection tool. So definitely go ahead and check that out. But those are just kind of a few ideas to run with. And now let's continue to make this market monitor dashboard from scratch for the purposes of the tutorial. So again, we've got a chart element that fills up the left-hand side of the screen. Then we've got three different deep lists that we want to add as well. So let's go over to tutorial. And let's go ahead and first of all, drag and drop this over here. Let's go ahead and expand this and get rid of it actually. And let's drag this chart element here. You can see I'm dragging and dropping using this icon here. And then in the corners, as you hover over that, you can go ahead and expand that to fill up that grid. So that looks pretty good. We'll go ahead and move this over here, expand this. And let's go ahead and drag one more deep list. That looks good. And then one more deep list as well. We'll drag down there. We'll expand that here. You can always kind of, you know, change the sizes as you wish after that. So let's go ahead and now load up the three different watch lists that we want. So you're going to have to create these for yourself. I've got one for index ETFs. I've got one for kind of the Mag 7, and then I've got one for kind of my group ETFs. So let's go ahead and type in theme ETFs. So that loads up this. And if you'd like, let me know in the comments down below if you'd like me to share this group ETF list. Basically, it's a deep list filled with kind of the group and theme ETFs that give you kind of a great top-down view of what's acting well in the market. You can really easily sort by percent change today, percent change 5 day, and see what was strongest today. You can see tech had a really nice move, miners as well, semiconductors acted well. And on the downside, you can see what acted negatively, mainly oil. You've got solar down here as well. And I've got a column set here that just has percent change today, the daily closing range, percent change over 5 days, WCR, price percent change from open, and AS rating 1 month. And that's basically what I use with this theme ETF deep list to quickly get a sense of what's working in the market from a group level. So that's kind of this deep list right here. Then over here, we're going to add this watch list here, which just has the liquid mega caps, Apple, Tesla, Amazon, Nvidia, Meta, Google, and Microsoft. Very similar column setup here, just to quickly show, you know, how do they perform today and how they've been trending recently. And then here, what we're going to do is do my index ETF deep list here. And we've got the QQQ, we've got the IWO, SPY, IWM, and FFTY. So we've basically already done with this right hand side of the market monitor setup. And we can go ahead and close this. You probably also want to go ahead and create a new layout. We'll call this market tutorial. Save that. And you can also go ahead and make a indicator template once we're done adding all the different indicators. So that's already looking very, very good. We can quickly go through all the different indexes. And let's go ahead and minimize this, hide that. And we can see, you know, how did the QQQ perform today? How did the IWO perform? SPY, let's check up on the Mag 7. You can do Apple, Tesla, Amazon, and then also you can go in ascending order from percent change today. You know, how did those individual groups perform? So very quickly, you can get a sense of the indexes, you know, the leadership, the liquid leaders here in the market, and those group ETFs. So we're already more than halfway there. And what's left, if we go back to my market monitor, is to add a few key indicators that help you, you know, analyze the breadth of the market. Let's go ahead and minimize that. We want to add the Deepvue net new highs, new lows indicator, as well as this breadth indicator down here. So let's go ahead and do that. And we also want to add, of course, that stage analysis indicator. So going back to the tutorial, let's first add those indicators, and let's go ahead and hide that again. And let's go ahead over to indicators and type in DV to bring up all the Deepvue specific indicators. We're first going to add that stage analysis, and we don't want it actually on our chart. You can definitely choose to do that if you would like, but we're going to go ahead and move that to a new pane above, and then, you know, move that up just so you can see that coloration, that, you know, that indicator signal. So if we go to the QQQ, go back to a weekly chart, you can see how it turned to a stage four downtrend during that 2022 bear market, and transitioned back to a stage two, you know, very early on in 2023. Just a nice visual indicator of that longer term trend, which you can use on both a weekly chart as well as a daily chart. So that's that settled. Let's go ahead and now add the Deepvue net new highs, new lows to the chart. And we're going to go ahead into settings, and you can choose your preference if you want to see NYSE, NASDAQ, AMEX, or kind of all of them together, USA. I prefer that personally. And this gives you a sense of, you know, the overall health, you know, how many stocks are making new highs versus new lows. During a correction, you'll see new highs proliferate and then breadth increase as a new uptrend begins. Very helpful indicator for confirmation of that breadth. And then lastly here, what we want to do is add in one more pane, and that will be the breadth indicator that we have, the stocks above the 40-day moving average on the NYSE. And to do that, what you want to do is basically click that comparison tool, give that a click, and then we're going to type in SA. And you can use that to find either stocks above the 200 SMA if you'd like to prefer that, but we're going to use the 40-day moving average here, and let's put that on a new pane. And there we go. That's pretty much our setup here. One thing I do want to do is I want to use my line tool to go ahead and draw over here a line here, just a reference guide right around 20 or so, because this often marks the lows of intermediate corrections. And, you know, during, you know, some more severe downtrends, you can even put that at 15 or 10, and that often marks a low in that breadth. And if you want to get rid of this label here, what you can do is right click here, go over to settings, scales, and uncheck symbol name right there. And we'll go ahead and make a copy of this, call this tutorial V2 Market Monitor. And we're also going to go ahead and save an indicator template for Market Monitor Tutorial. And we'll go ahead and check remember symbol just so it brings up the QQQ. You know, if we load that up again, you can definitely, you know, this is personal preference here. So that is pretty much it. My other setup didn't have RMV. So if you want to exit that out, you can go ahead and do that. But again, very quickly, you can run through the health of the market, starting with the index ETFs, the IWO, and just scroll through those. Then you can also take a look at the Mag 7, the group ETFs, and get a really good sense of that top-down analysis. What groups are strong? Where is that rotation going? Where is the money flowing? So I think this is a really helpful setup that I highly recommend you check out. Hopefully you learned something new. Let me know if you did down below. And if you have any questions whatsoever about Deepvue, also leave them down below in the comment section. We'll try to answer every single one. And again, if you haven't yet tried Deepvue and are curious about it, this is a really great time to give it a shot with that special offer, 2 months for only $39. Really a steal. Yeah, definitely recommend checking it out. This is my daily driver for market analysis, you know, trade execution, screening, watchlist management, the whole nine yards. So I really think you'll find it incredibly valuable. So thank you so much for tuning in. Leave a like down below if you did enjoy, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and I'll see you guys in future videos. Take care.